To think that Kia used to be completely set on beating Volkswagen suddenly has Tesla on its radar. With dynamic driving, 300 plus miles of range, and loads of tech, might the new Kia EV6 be one of the greatest electric vehicles on the market? For a long time, they have been known for their basic, reasonable, practical, and, to be honest, mostly boring economical cars. Then, by fearlessly embracing the electric vehicle revolution long before most of its competitors, they built a new reputation as the champions of long-range, relatively inexpensive, but still slightly boring electric cars, namely the eNIRO, Soul, Ioniq, and Kona. And now comes the important step, redefining their image and transforming themselves into an attractive brand you buy into because you actually want one, not merely for the enticement of a lengthy warranty and a plethora of cup holders. It's a completely new vehicle that competes with the Nissan Ariya, Ford Mustang Mach-E, and Volkswagen ID.4. There's no battery option, unlike most of its competitors. The EV6 has a lithium-ion battery with a usable capacity of 77.4 kWh and a total capacity of 82.5 kWh. That's somewhat more powerful than the Model 3's top-end powertrain, but it's swamped by the Mustang Mach-E's top-end E's powertrain. However, there are two engine options, a single-motor rear-wheel drive with 229 horsepower and a dual-motor all-wheel drive with 326 horsepower. The battery pack is placed beneath the floor between the two axles, as is standard procedure to maintain the low center of gravity and reduce cabin intrusion. While the EV6 has the same fundamental philosophy as the Ioniq 5, it has a smaller boot space, just 520 liters, which feels much more intimate. Inside the Ioniq 5, it's big on the sensation of interior volume. The EV6 isn't, and is much more driver-focused from the start. There's more direct and distinct steering, and greater body control. This is still a more than 2-ton electric SUV, and sharper response. Sport mode, which can be reached through the little paddle on the bottom left-hand side of the steering wheel, increases throttle response, along with steering weight and a red for danger indicator and more artificial noise. But it also makes the EV6 feel so much more committed. And it's quick. The throttle mapping may not have the neck-breaking shock response of something like a Porsche Taycan, but it's perfectly judged and can pull away from just about anything but a full-on sports car from standstill, even in this mid-range 2-motor version. Having said that, it's worth noting that this isn't a light B road dissector. The EV6's sheer size and weight need caution in narrow lanes, while A roads are handled with the effortless nonchalance that really excellent electric vehicles excel at. The quality appears to be excellent, and the number of gadgets will have button fetishists salivating from anything from sophisticated ADAS, the anti-lock braking system, the brake assist system, driver mode select, and electronic stability control, to Bluetooth connectivity, forward collision avoidance assistance, and city, pedestrian, cycle, and junction turning assistance, highway driving assistance, intelligence speed limit assistance, and so forth. It's outfitted with the most up-to-date safety equipment, including an anti-theft alarm system, interior door lock and unlock function, immobilizer, locking wheel nuts, and a visible vehicle identification number. And this is just the standard security system. It also has traditional passive security. The interior information portal is made up of two 12.3-inch panels. One on the left-hand side is a touchscreen. One on the front is info only, and there are genuine knobs to adjust temperature and a haptic bar between them to accomplish everything else, including a heated steering wheel, metal-painted inside door handles, navigation-based smart cruise control with stop-and-go capabilities, as well as paddle shifters for selecting driving mode, cruise control, and controls on the steering wheel. Sun visors with vanity mirror LED illumination for both the driver and front passenger, tilt and telescopic steering wheel adjustment, and vegan leather-covered steering wheel are just a few of the standard features. It's well organized, though it would take more than a minute to figure out all of the different features. It's detailed, though, and feels forward-thinking rather than a collection of pieces. Overall, it's pretty darn amazing. If you want to make a statement, the EV6 is a terrific choice. It has a prominent face, broad haunches, and a sloping roof. And the curved lighting bar at the rear reminds me of an Aston Martin DBX. Unlike the Aston Martin, the base model will most likely cost around $45,000, before a $7,500 federal tax credit and any state incentives are applied. When it comes to the exterior features and lighting, it's equipped with automatic headlight control, adjustable heated door mirrors with integrated LED indicator lights, a rear spoiler that makes the competition seem like a joke, LED rear combo lights, and LED daytime running lights. And what about the crucial range, you might ask? If the outside temperature is in the fridge setting or below, you'll need the optional heat pump to get close to the all-wheel drive's WLTP range. This is 314 miles, or 300 miles if you choose our GT Line S with 20-inch wheels. In any case, that's highly useful, but not revolutionary. If you're wondering how much horsepower and torque the EV6 has, you've come to the right place. There are four distinct variants of the EV6, each with its own set of specifications. A rear-wheel drive model with a 58.0kW battery combined with a 160kW rear motor producing 167 horsepower. A rear-wheel drive model with 77.4kWh battery combined with a 160kW rear motor producing 225 horsepower. An all-wheel drive model at 77.4kW battery combined with a 70kW front motor and a 160kW rear motor producing 320 total horsepower. The GT variant has 77.4kW battery, a 167kW front motor, and a 270kW rear motor for a total of 576 horsepower. When it comes to charging, the EV6, like its Hyundai Ioniq brother, excels. Kia appears to be laser-focused on boosting charging speeds, which might make EV ownership significantly less onerous, providing public charging networks can keep up. The vehicle is capable of charging at both 800 and 400 volts. The EV6 can charge its 77.4kW battery pack from 10 to 80% in just 18 minutes using a 350kW charger. This equates to a gain of roughly 210 miles. If you have time for a quick charge, it may add up to 68 miles of range in 5 minutes. With a 240 volt, 40 amp charger, the 11 kilowatt onboard charger can fill the bigger battery on a home level 2 charger in just 7 hours. A vehicle to load or a V2L system is the second innovative feature. In layman's words, this implies the car's charging outlet can power home goods like a kettle or a microwave, as well as charge another EV. That can come in useful. The electricity goes off, and if for any reason you have a microwave in your car and need to reheat a meal. When it comes to the ultimate judgment, I will say that the EV6 is excellent. The EV6 carves a totally different route dynamically to the Hyundai Ioniq 5, which it shares bones with and blood. It's distinctive, but not going to tumble over a fashionable cliff. Fun to drive, but not likely to frighten a dedicated sports car. That's not a negative thing. However, it's also a large, quiet, and competent cruiser. There are less powerful two-wheel drive models on the way, as well as the much more powerful GT. And it's one of those vehicles that makes you believe other manufacturers are lagging behind the Korean pure electric offering. The software is simple to use, and it includes Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, something the Model 3 does not have. Inside, it's a lot more tolerable than the vexing VW ID.4, and far more useful than the Polestar 2. It's very spacious, and there's lots of room up front, while passengers will have plenty of room and legroom in the back, and there's plenty of level floor, so an adult can use the middle seat without a complaint. Because of the sloping roofline though, only headroom might be a little limited for tall people. The EV6 tackles the issues of the e-Niro being overly proficient but bland. It's both highly competent and distinctive enough to stand out, even with a significant platform share on the eGMP platform. Yes, it's hardly a little vehicle on the typical British B road, or anywhere else for that matter, but it's not much worse than any other higher riding SUVs. Yes, the tendency for neurotic safety systems with concomitant bongs and cheeps and bleeps may excite people who pay attention to Euro NCAP ratings, it's impossible to deny that this is a well thought out, well-rounded, intriguing, and gratifying vehicle from Kia. And I wouldn't be wrong if I said it's the best electric car you can purchase right now. It also keeps rival manufacturers on their toes.